हेलो क्लास फोर्थ, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। यस, टुडे वी आई विल टेक योर चैप्टर चैप्टर सिक्स, दैट इज प्रोनाउंस, फ्रॉम योर ग्रामर बुक। एंड होप यू ऑल हैव डन योर लिटरेचर वर्क एंड योर सिलेबस इज बीइंग कंप्लीटेड। एंड डू ऑल प्रिपेयर फॉर योर हाफ एलिज एग्जाम एज इट इज कमेंसिंग सून। सो लेट अस रीड चैप्टर सिक्स। अ वर्ड which is used in place of noun is called pronoun. So it helps in avoiding the repetition of some nouns. It makes the sentence easier to read. So what the pronoun do? It makes the sentence easier to read. So for example, Aurav is 9 years old. He reads in class 4. So if in place of he, what you will write? Aurav. So you have to take the name two times. Aurav को Aurav का नाम आपको दो बार लिखना पड़ेगा। So in place of Aurav you can use he, or if the girl's name is there then you can use the she word. So it is easier for us ना। We are not we don't have to take the name two times. So like Mr. Shukla was very busy. He was hanging bright lights over the house. So in the above sentence the colored words are pronoun. There are many types of pronoun. We will read three of them in this class. So personal pronoun are used in place of the noun that name the people. They are three types. First person is the person who is speaking, like I, we, me, you, us. Second person is the person or things which is spoken to you, thee, thou. Third person is the person or thing which is spoken of he, she, and him, her, they, them, and it. For example, I is, then when we use I as a subject, then me, we, are, you, she, her, he, his, him, they, them, and their. So now see the possessive pronouns stand for the people who have possession of something, like who have the ownership of something, like this car is hers, that book is mine, this pen is yours, that toy is his. So what the possessive pronoun tells you about the ownership of the thing. So like this book is yours, then who will be the owner of this book? You na. So this book is yours. So it is telling the possession of this book, its ownership of the book. Now see the reflexive pronouns are used as object of the verb. They are formed by adding self or selves. The chicken are making kites themselves. Rakesh will clean this room himself. So myself is ourself, himself and themself, herself and themself, and yourself. So the chapter is this much only, I think. So hope you all have understood till here. And as the chapter is very small, so I am continuing the chapter 7 also in this video. Please go through it and open chapter number 7 from your book. So chapter 5-7 adjective, I am continuing in this video. A word that qualifies a noun or pronoun is called adjective. An adjective is also called a describing word. Adjectives are added to nouns to state what kind and what color, which one or how many. So let us read the example. The apple is sweet. What kind of apple is that? It is sweet apple. So it is telling about the quality of noun and pronoun. It is telling the quality of a person or a thing. So the sum is easy. What kind of sum is it? It's easy. So it tells about the degrees of adjective quality. So now see this. Everyone, adjective of quality describes the kind of quality of a noun or pronoun. It can be expressed in any of the following ways. No comparison, comparison between two, comparison with many. We use different degrees of adjectives of quality as. So positive degree for no comparison. and comparative degree for comparison between two or two groups, and superlative degree for comparison with many. So what the positive degree do? It do not compare anything. And what the comparative degree also compares between two or more than two. Like you have there are two sisters, and you say na Geeta is taller than her sister. So superlative degree, and there are three sisters, and what you say the you will say na Geeta is tallest among all. So what is the tallest? We are comparing between many people. So see the example, Rani is tall girl, so it is a positive degree. It's actual thing means Rani is taller than Nupur. It's a comparative degree because Rani is comparing to Nupur. So Rani is the tallest in our group, and we are talking about many, and Rani is the tallest among all the from all in the group. So it is superlative degree. So here you hope you all have understood this much. So see here in the first sentence, quality of Rani is that she is tall, but this quality of her is not compared with anyone. So hence tall is expressed in positive degree. And in the second tense, Rani quality of being tall is compared with Nupur. As I told you that Rani's quality is being compared with Nupur. Quality is being tall and expressed as taller in comparative degree. So comparative degree compares between two, and the superlative degree, it compares among all. So see the next page. In the third sentence, Rani quality of being tall is compared with all the members in group, hence it is expressed as tallest in the superlative degree. So see, some examples are given: small, smaller and smallest, busy, busier and busiest, nice, nicer and nicest. So go through this example. These are very helpful for you all in further chapters and as well as in your further life. So see the use of then and the, where we all use the then and the. Comparative degree is lowered by then, while superlative degree is preceded by the in a sentence. For example, Raj is wiser than Aman. Reema is younger than Aman. She is the tallest in our class. Delhi is colder than Hyderabad. So where we use than and the comparative degree is phase to lower by then and while superlative degree is preceded by the. So go all through these exercise examples, and we will be doing the exam all the exercises with the help of your worksheets. The worksheet will be sent to you all soon. So please do all complete the works and have a nice day, and all the best for your Hafele's exam. Please do good and use good handwriting, so that it will be easier for me to check, and you will get the good marks. As you all have done good in your unit test also, so please do try your best to do best in your Hafele's exam. All the best. Take care. Have a nice day.